This Lucia, and I just heard, you know what? Hold on. Ne. Znaš kako? Ne, daj da je primio malo masla u ovu. Perfect.
Kasnim tamo, kasnim. 50 sekundi.
Da, znam. Okay, I can't. Can you see it there? Kako izgleda? Oh, now we're. How come it went that way?
Kasnit, dođi da vidiš.
So look how now it's coming. No, something. Let's see.
How are you, sir? Good to see you. Happy New Year.
How's everything?
Thanks for coming.
Pleasure.
devojčice? Hey, girls.
Thank you.
Thank you.
și așa, chestii de care și știi.
Da,
ok. De asta.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, there's chicken.
Yeah.
Nelly, you want me to repeat that? Yes. The second of us? Poi nasce il concerto, subito stesso di Manco.
Ha subito un
Хлебот наш потребен дай ни го денес, но
Prostenik dolgovite naši, kako nije što bi proždeo na naši dolžnici. I ne ne povede bi iskušenje, da izbavimo od lukavi od. Amin. Uvedite se. Očitovani, dozvolite od imetu na upravljen odbor Makedonska dobrovoslavna crkva, Sv. Petar i Pavle, od svoje lično ime, od imetu na site nas, da ve pozdravim, da ve posakam prijedan predstav ova Makedonska sredina, iako do svekoj dne semestva naše pristigna pokanata za prisutstvo ova večer, vremenskite uslovi na istina овие последни денови не ни дозволуваат и не заплашуваат дека вакви собиралишни и слични работи не можеме да ги одржиме за наша голема радост, а за жал, бидејќи ова вечер сме собрани, помногу брено да бидеме дел од борбата што ја води нашата пријателка тука. Лично ја познавам. Еден голем пријател помагач на Сибија кој работеше денанок на во Македонскиот конзулат во Чикаго, Тонка беше радост за сите нас и со многу чест и достоинство не пречекуваше и даваше упатства, утехи и многу нешта. Затоа, наистина, од длабочината на срцето ве молам да се помолиме, Господе и помоли. А исто така го поздравувам и овој ваш вечерашен собир и посакувам успешна работа, раководени од страна на нашиот председател на ИРД, господин Петро Коловски. Вистина, ве читаме, ве пратиме, посакуваме многу радост и многу успеси за тоа што вие го отворивте прозорецот на светот, за да не видат нас. Ви благодарам. Поздрав до сите.
Before we continue with our program, I would just like to take a moment to thank several very special people that made tonight possible. Despite various challenges and setbacks, obviously, we still were able to come together, and I'm very proud of tonight's event. On our planning committee, and great thanks to Joko Zoran Trajko and Nevena Trajko. Also, very special thanks to our church, the church board, our priest, our partner in organizing tonight's event, Yasmina Bishop, Nevena and Kalina, who will entertain us endlessly this evening, as well as Blagoj Mlado, an international and recognized musician. Duško Simic is also here with us tonight, which I'm sure you'll enjoy his performance. And we're honored to also have Robert Johnson, the Director of Europe from Senator Mark Kirk's Office of Illinois. Thank you so much to our sponsors for this evening. And next, I would like to call the Consul General of Macedonia in Chicago, Gospodin Jakub Nejek.
Специјално и на Република Македонија. harmonije. Ovo je bilo namenjeno za humanitarne cilje, spomenuo i to na pokojni od zvezda Toše Projevski, koji se ušte ne gledam teka ti po bliske jedina ti imamo jedna mila zvezda o svekoj aspekti o humanitarnom, no večero turi i odeden čovjek da se počne taj želba da se pomaga, da se pomaga na dom, kad ne treba da li je prestalo mjesto, ja znajete, ste imali mnogo česti telefonski kontakt i lični, pred da se otvori konzulata to bovo Čikago, siti raboti ga ima šeše, Detroit. Osim ta, jaz uspeja se dom, kada i so rabotuvam drbe v Čikago, odnosno beše Donka v Detroit. Mislim da ga nemaše prostor nikoga što Donka čovjek da bide, da ne bide sreće da raboti da zborovak i pred koga sluša pred da se zamine za lingovanje. I vo ta sostojba ta se ušte delovaše sveža, ohrabrujački. И едноставно вака рече, не се сомнявам дека нашите граѓани ќе соберат повеќе пари кога е потребно за некој незино лекување. Туку е само сеја на Господ и на нашите молитви да им бидат помогнат и да ја гледаме да се врати во нормалниот живот, да и Господ, како викат, cancer free, да биде слободен од тоа. Ja s ovom prilike bi sakal da je koristan, iako po malo broj, kako što reče, popot tome ne dozvolovat vremenskite uslovi, javno da ne povikujem koja će se stopat, vremenskite uslovi koja će dozvolovat. Jedno ovako druženje da imame, po pogolik broj na relacija generalnog konzulata, odnosno konzulata kako servis na našite građani i vaše to rakovostvo, tuk da ga izvestite ljudjeto, тоа се вика едноставно да организираме конзуларни денови кај што ние ќе бидеме поблиску до вас и ќе можеме да ви информираме и некои работи што можеме на лице место да ги завршиме. И една дилема со попот го зборевме, која се појавува, може би имейли добивате поединечно. Индијана и физички е поблиску до Чикаго и припадја на Чикаго, за да можеме да ме услужиме. Тоа ќе го направиме со Господ напред во наредните недели која ќе се стопли времето. Благодарам за поканата и за присуството кое го имате тук. И посакувам уште понатаму поголеми успеси да имате во аспект на организирање. И една или молба или порака до сите вас. Обединете да македонска диаспора или UMD, јас се сеќавам на 2005 во Вашингтон, бев негде 2006, може би случајно се среднаме со сегашниот председател Мето Коловски, кој волонтерски заедно со неколку наши иселеници пријатели ја почна оваа акција и како да посакувавме и двајцата да ово се професионализира и да биде професионална, така да кажем, организација која е на вистина од Вашингтон и сите ги приставува интересите на македонската нација, на македонската држава и мислам дека тоа добро го прави, но ќе го направи уште повеќе и подобро ако има и вашата поддршка и финансиска поддршка нормално. Но со една напомена и до UMD и до локалните организации нема ривалство, има само соработка помеѓу тие организации. Овие кои се по сојузни држави ја имаат својата важна улога и ја заслужуваат поддршката од UMD и обратно. Овие да не поддржат UMD. Така ви посакувам да делувате, да функционирате, ако сакаме да достигнеме целта, да ја представиме македонската држава, да ја образложиме политиките на македонската влада, без оглед која е идеја, која е била, која е или која ќе дојде, ќе секогаш работат во интерес на државата. А вие заедно можете тоа подалеку и поблабоко да ја прикажете. Благодарам.
At this point, I'd like to invite the President of the United Macedonian Diaspora, Meto Kolovski.
technology these days, you can read your speech on an iPad. I just bought one recently. I'm not very high-tech savvy. But I'm going to start first in Macedonian and then in English for the presentation. But prvo sretna nova godina na site vas prisutni deneska vi posakvam sve najdobro vo 2014. Vo životu bereket zdravje i prosperitet i uspeh, особено и на нашата црковна заедница. Много сакам да се заблагодарам до Бог Томе и господино там Чайков, кој е исто и член на нашата организација и целосната управа, што возможите да видиме тука денеска. Бројката мене не ме плаши никога, јас, како што на времето Господ почна, Исус Христос почна со еден, и па со еден и повеќе и повеќе, и полека групата на луѓе, на христијани, растеше така и мислам и работата на UMD. Еден, и полека ќе биде по масо. Така да ви благодарам многу. So now I'm going to start in English. Thank you, St. Peter and Paul Church, Father Tome and Tom Chekhov and Marian, and also for the church community who's helping us with this event. We really appreciate our long-standing collaboration, and I congratulate you and your community once again on the 50th anniversary of being the oldest church in North America. You organized a first-rate convention last year, Labor Day, and we commend you, and we're very happy to be with you during that time. I would want to thank my committee members. First, Natalia, our Director of Charitable Affairs, recently board member, and Chicago representative, which eventually somebody else will take that role now that she's a board member of these things. Zoran, Joko, Nevena, Trajko, as well. Without them, this event would not have been possible. Our musicians, Blagoj, Duško, Karina, and Nevena, thank you very much for everything that you're going to be doing today. Thank you to our volunteers, Ashley, Angie, Vera, today. Thank you, Consul General. I've been a very good friend of UMD since 2005. I remember finally taking the metro with him to the embassy. I would get off at another route, he would get off, and we'd constantly debate topics on Macedonia. Around from Senator Kirk's office, we've had a very strong collaboration with your office in the last couple of years, and we hope to enhance that relationships. I want to thank some of our sponsors for this evening, Turkish Airlines, Drs. Anastas and Nala Mukoski, Katerina Kuzdanovski, Judge Michael Serafin, Alexander Petinski. Also, just in addition to Natalia, our Director of Charitable Affairs, and our Director of Cultural Affairs, came down from Windsor, Canada to be here with us, and Trajko, our Director of U.S. Operations, which is from the community here and is handling all of our operations throughout America. Thank you, Angie. We love Donka. She's a very strong woman, and we are very hopeful that everything will go smoothly with her treatments. Donka is one of the most professional people I have met in my 10 years with UMD, and I want to thank all of you for coming out tonight and supporting Donka. Half of this evening's proceeds will be donated for Donka's treatment. So thank you, Angie, and she will say a few words a little bit later. Very briefly, presentation, because I don't want to extend the presentations and speeches, but really briefly about UMD. We were formed in 2004, October 28th actually, thanks to some people at the State Department. And they said, how come there's no unitary body for Macedonians in Washington? And we said, that's a good question. We didn't have, we had so many church organizations, other organizations, but never an organization in Washington, D.C. And a bunch of us, about 12 or 13, got together at a Starbucks, believe it or not, and we decided that we're going to form an organization that's going to represent Macedonian Americans. And slowly that organization grew to not only having an office in Washington, and since 2009 a professional staff, but also an office in Toronto, an office in Melbourne, And most recently, we just opened up a UND Europe, and appointed our first director, our first director of European operations, Olivier from The Hague, who will represent UND in Brussels and register UND Europe. So now we will be fully on all continents, and obviously membership throughout the world. Why Washington, D.C.? Obviously, Washington, D.C., we're, as Americans, we're biased. It is the center of power in the world. And Washington is the place to be if you want to make an impact, especially for Macedonia. Up until 2004, everybody had a federal. All our neighbors in the region that probably are not so supportive of Macedonia's future in NATO and EU and others had free reign on Washington. There was nobody to combat their arguments or present facts from our side on what's going on. And you know, we now have access to policymakers. You know, and one example is Robert from Senator Kirk's office. And not only in Washington, but our representatives throughout the US are building relations with their members of Congress. We have a Congressional Caucus on Macedonia since 2011. It's the first time a caucus in the US Congress exists with the name Macedonia. So if you want recognition, here's your recognition. The US Congress has a members association called Congressional Caucus on Macedonia and Macedonian Americans, and Congressman Pete Viskovsky from this district is a member of that caucus. Thanks to your community, building relations with Congressman Pete Viskovsky. I just want to reiterate a few of our policies statements or side of things. The name of Macedonia is Macedonia. UMD's policy is to make sure that we have that right to be called Macedonia. We don't agree to a change of Macedonia's name, and we will fight to ensure that Macedonia has that right. We're very pleased that the US and 134 countries recognize Macedonia, but we have a lot of work to do. Germany doesn't recognize us, France doesn't recognize us. 11 countries in the European Union still don't recognize Macedonia as Republic of Macedonia. So we have a lot of work to do. Human rights issues. Macedonians in Greece and Bulgaria and other countries don't have equal rights of what we have today in America, for example. We can freely state we're Macedonian, but in countries like Greece and Bulgaria, you can't do that. And we want to make sure that our brothers and sisters, our fellow Macedonians in those countries, have a voice and representation. And I can report that through some of our efforts, the Law Library of Congress did a report in October 2012 on minority rights in Greece and what's the current situation of Macedonians and Turks and Albanians and other minorities in Greece. So that's on the advocacy side of things. I want to also mention more of our charitable programs. Growing up in Garfield, New Jersey, there was no Macedonian scholarship. There was an application to fill out for a scholarship, a Macedonian American Businessman Scholarship. And I filled out, and other Macedonians in my class filled out, and then when time for scholarship season came to get scholarships, they said, well, your community never gave money for the scholarship. And, you know, okay. You say, better luck to other students in the future. Hopefully they have money. And I got a scholarship from a Polish church because they thought Kowalski is a Polish last name. So thanks to the Polish church for giving me a scholarship. But so when we formed UMD, that's one of the first things that we wanted to do is give and offer Macedonian students people that we want to have a future. We have to invest in the future of our youth. So we received a $50,000 grant from John Mitoff from Toronto to give out a series of scholarships per year, and hopefully that will grow, and we are still fundraising to give out even more. This year we had about 20 applicants for the scholarship. Usually we give out about 3 or 4, and we received an overwhelming, and I'm talking about people, students that are studying at Yale and Harvard and Cambridge and others, and I'm really pleased
to see that Macedonian students in these fields. So investing in the youth. We also have an internship program in Washington. We host about 10 students. We've had Macedonians from France, from Canada, from Australia, from Macedonia even come to intern at our office in Washington. Our office is centrally located. We're next door to the White House. Easy access to the White House, State Department, Congress, and think tank community. So our interns are not pushing paper. I can tell you I used to work for a congressman, an intern, and then worked, but when I was an intern, I think I stuffed 10,000 envelopes. And I was like, that's not the type of internship that I want to have. So we want to offer these students more opportunities, and we send them out throughout town to represent UMD, because that's how you build the future careers of these people, by throwing them in the line of fire and going to think tank events and other things. So one of our scholarship recipients, Neda Meneshkuska, is here from a couple of years ago. So she's one of the singers and musicians for this evening. I also want to mention our charitable work. Every year we organize an IVA 5K run walk, which basically IVA is our Macedonian caviar, that I like to call the vegetable pate, but IVA and 5K run for orphans. We had one 2 years in Washington, one in Ann Arbor, Michigan. We also had one in New York City. It's every year on September 8th, which is Macedonia's Independence Day. And next year, this year actually, we're at Chicago, Toronto, and most likely Macedonia. Skopje Marathon has expressed interest in hosting this event. Last summer, we also had a Maksudov health clinic in Macedonia where we helped 330 Macedonian patients, elderly children, to receive free health care in the Strumica region and medication because of the flood situation back in February. We're working on a CD project with the Smithsonian right now. It's a $70,000 project to have a Macedonian traditional music from the 1920s, which is being reworked, and the Smithsonian Folkways Recording has decided to publish this CD with a book, and hopefully that will come about sometime this spring. And then a few other projects that we're working on. We'll have a leadership conference in June, a few galas. We're also going to have a flag-raising ceremony at Wall Street for Macedonian Independence Day. That's going to be the first time. And then just briefly, and then probably Rob will tell us a little bit more, but I just want to focus on immigration reform. That's a very big issue for our community, because obviously the U.S. was built on immigrants. The first Macedonian, some say, was Dragan Vohrid, who came in 1492 with Christopher Columbus, but you don't know how to verify that. But, you know, that's where people are saying. So waves of Macedonians started coming in the 1900s, the turn of the century, World War I, World War II, 60s through 80s, and then the recent immigration to America in the 90s and in the 2000s. And, you know, some of the history, you know, at the turn of the century, Macedonians were the ones building the railroads among other immigrants in Chicago. So that's something for us to be proud of, and we want to add to that. And we've been invited by several members of Congress, as well as the White House, to be participants of a roundtable on immigration reform to add our perspective. And actually, a group of Macedonian Americans are going to the White House on February 7th for a White House Ethnic Day to discuss immigration reform, foreign policy, and other topics. So we're very pleased that we're at the table. Global Macedonian advocacy, united we can. So immigration, another topic is visa waiver program. We have been working in support of the Polish community for Poland to get a visa waiver program, because we believe that once Poland gets a visa waiver program, the door will be open for other countries like Macedonia, hopefully, which is a small, you know, 2.1 million, but we want free visa access to America. And Macedonians have free, no visas for Europe, and we believe that eventually Macedonians should be able to travel without visas to America. So that's, hopefully immigration reform will pass very soon. We've seen some positive steps, but I want to thank you all for participating tonight. I'm not going to take any more of your time. UMD is only strong thanks to your support. So those of you that are not members, I encourage you to become members and support UMD, our Macedonian Companions program, and to donate, but get involved. You don't have to donate or become a member necessarily to get involved, because every letter, every phone call, anything that you do to spread Macedonia and Macedonia's culture really is important. So we are all ambassadors for the Macedonian homeland, even though some of us may be first, second, third generation Macedonians, so we have something to be proud of. So on your way out, please feel free to grab more information, and hopefully afterwards we'll have some dancing. So I guess we'll invite Robert Johnson from Senator's office.
I do, unfortunately, Senator, he was not able to join us here today, but I'd like to read a letter on his behalf. Dear friends, it gives me great pleasure to offer a sincere welcome to everyone here tonight for the United Macedonia Diaspora's Winter Extravaganza. While I regret being unable to join you, I would like to commend all the distinguished guests and individuals here in attendance. The United Macedonia Diaspora has played an integral role in serving the Macedonian American community across the United States, through your honorable goals of preserving Macedonian heritage, promoting citizenship, and participation in the political process, you have brought important issues to light and encouraged the betterment of countless individuals. I look forward to continuing to work tirelessly on your behalf and best serve you in the United States Senate. Again, my heartfelt congratulations go out to all of you tonight. I'd like to commend UMD President Mato Kowalski, Italian Bowling, and the rest of the UMD board for their continued vision, leadership, and guidance. I also have a special thanks to Consul General Rezepi and also the staff here at the St. Peter and Paul Cathedral. All who contribute to the success of the organization can certainly take pride in all that has been accomplished and look forward to an even brighter and more promising future. Very truly yours, U.S. Senator Mark Kirk.
At this point, I'd like to invite Professor Nevena Dreko to come and educate us on her current project with UMD to create the first ever Macedonian journal on a variety of Macedonian topics and questions. So please welcome Professor Dreko.
Hi, double mission. To speak in English though, but we have some speakers here that may not understand Macedonian fully, so I'll speak in English. Plus, I lecture in English, it's just easier for me.
Yeah.
So, this past summer, UMD held its fourth annual global conference in our capital, Macedonian Skopje, and I headed the academic conference of portion of the conference, I should say. And the turnout that we had was pretty amazing. I put out a call for papers in all the major sociological, political, historical journals within the disciplines, not just to the United States, but actually all over the world. And it gave us a really great response. We had so many people submit abstracts. We're talking scholars who were hungry for an opportunity to express their research on Macedonian questions and matters. So of the people that participated in the conference, you can see that from the journal book that we put out for the conference itself, the agendas, the programs, We had people coming from 26 different countries. For the scholars from the academic conference, we had over 40 presentations. We didn't have enough time. We were so tight on time at the conference. It was kind of like, oh, we need another day. Like, can we make this 4 days? Because there was just so much to talk about and so much to do with all the other stuff going on in the program. We had 40 professors from 12 different countries participate. And the highlighting factor was that not most of the professors were from Macedonia. We had professors from Switzerland, from Germany, from Romania, some very memorable Romanians. I think we all fell in love with Romanians that came down that delegation. From England, of course from Canada, from the United States. There were professors from Macedonia. We had a PhD from Oxford who's Greek by heritage, who wanted to show us his research, and he had very logical, practical, rational research of, yes, you are Macedonians, you should call yourself Macedonians, but he didn't serve the military, so we had a difficult time getting over the border into Macedonia. The Greeks wouldn't let him out. I call it a propaganda, but that's a different story. We had a wonderful conference. There was so much to learn, so many questions, research questions on the themes of the 100 years since the Treaty of Bucharest divided the Macedonian territory. And we had themes from, you know, the effects of the treaty, what was happening while the treaty was being taking place, the effects of the Balkan Wars, all the way to modern day issues within Macedonia, of human rights issues, minority issues within our own country that we need to reflect, Macedonians as a minority in other countries, and again, just this wealth of knowledge that is really professional academic research. This is no longer a time for, you know, what, as I like to call it, Andrea from the cello, or Andrea from the village, what he has to say. This is now a time that we need to really get our academics and get professors encouraged and motivated to research these Macedonian questions. Because when we want to make foreign policy, when we want to encourage and influence foreign policy, these think tanks turn to academics. They turn to people like me who research questions on whatever issue that they want to find a position on. So it is my mission to get these professors, not necessarily Macedonian background, but of all backgrounds, to research academically, rigorously, significantly, unbiased, objectively, on some of the issues that we have. And that's only going to strengthen our position in these think tanks that provide Congress, that provide our politicians with information for how to move forward in policy-making decisions. So what we decided to do was, from the 40-some papers that we have from the conference, we're going to actually publish it as a journal. The first ever journal of academic papers solely on Macedonian questions. We have never had anything like this yet. And the journals that do exist usually revolve around works of people of Macedonian heritage. And I am so pleased that the majority of our works will not be that. The majority of our works will be for professors from different countries, from different nationalities, from different backgrounds. And I think it's a unique thing to have. So this journal, the University of Skopje, the Faculty of Philosophy is helping to fund it. But with all 40-some papers, one book is going to be about 800 pages. It's a big thing. So part of the proceeds from tonight will be going towards helping to fund the publication of that journal. I really do hope that the community comes together and supports this project. You know, as a professor, I'm a little bit biased. I have a little bit of a heavy weight on the importance of professional research. But also as a professor of political science who teaches world politics and comparative politics as a concentration, I can tell you that this will make a difference, that we will finally have an academic book that our think tanks and our politicians can reference, as opposed to just the average person who may have a bit of a skewed or emotional response to these. So these are very important projects, especially this journal that UMD is sponsoring. And I really do hope that as you support UMD, that you would also think back on this project and encourage others to support this project and make it an annual thing. So I thank you for your time, and I look forward to talking to some of you afterwards if you have any questions.
Thank you, Nana. At this time, I'd like to invite Dronka's daughter, Angie, to come up and share a few words with us about about their initiative to help Donka and how we can all work together to help her mom.
Bravo, dobro večer. Ja sam Inči, Stojanovska, Angela. Prvo sada da bih blagovala mnogo što dojelate večer i mnogo bih blagovala što kaj razvredite, tako da mi je ponesno da zbogom po Angelici. Okay. Thank you for everything. My mom, she's coming back tonight from this hospital in Mexico called Oasis of Hope. She's coming back around 1 in the morning. So I'm going to see her tomorrow when I'm home. Excited, but everything involving cancer we know is expensive, and all the help that you give and everybody gives is more than I can thank you for with my words, and I just want to give you all a big hug and just get everything over with. My mom would be better, and nothing would be possible without everybody's support, so I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you so much for joining us, Angie. It means a lot to us that you came, and we're happy that we can be here for you and your mom in any way. At this point, I'd like to share a little surprise with you. Nevena Nashkoska, who is a recipient of one of the UMD scholarships, would like to share a few words with all of us about her experience in gaining the scholarship. So please welcome Nevena.
Thank you, Natalia. That was a surprise to me as well. all right, well, I know my girl is going to prom. Should I prom? I'm Islam. Борам кој човек се. Па да им се заблагодарам на македонската дијаспора што ми ја подарија стипендија за 2011. Баш таа година не би сигурна дали понастоа ќе можев така финансиски да преживеам таа година, зашто имав баш одбојки часови и не ми беше до скрос платено школото, па треба да прекинам да работам, за да можам да се фокусирам за нашата. И фала Богу, македонската дијаспора, мислам аплицирав и се, ми ја поклонија стипендијава. И што знам јас, мислам, баш во моментот ми помогна, можам да си купам книги и навреме да си ги купам, на место да чекам од Амазон за поевтино да ми испадне и така на така. И мислам, за мене не е баш само тоа стипендијата, преку тоа што ми ја поклонија стипендијата, јас можев и да задржам контакт со дијаспора во Македонија, сега што отворија баш бренч, и да можам на некој начин да им вратам за тогаш пред 3 години кога ми помогна финансиски, и мило ми е што можам на како билен начин да им помогна, мислам, со промовирање и се тоа. Затоа ви благодарам пак. И толку фала.
Surprises keep things fun. So at this point, we'd like to conclude our presentation. And in conclusion, I want to leave you with one last thought. I think that you have a good picture, a clear picture of the variety of projects and the scope and depth of what UMD does, and how important the role of UMD is in maintaining our community and our identity. So I would like to invite all of you, if you are not already members, to please become a member tonight. So in conclusion, thank you so much for coming. I look forward to working with all of you in securing our work, and now we're going to have some fun. We have a wonderful presentation for music with Vlad Guilano and Nevanay Kalina. So thank you all for coming, and now we have some fun.
Да, я сейчас не знаю, что с ними, знаешь, что с ними. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
ove ključe probane, da malce se ne prosti.
Sve to
Dobre dovedovte, vidí koľko?
Kako si moče?
Dobre.
Pole?
Thank you. Thank you.
Velike hvala.
For you now, maybe an instrument that you haven't heard in a long time.
Zurla.
Zurla. Is that one? Yeah. Just a reminder, we are doing a raffle. So if you haven't purchased your raffle tickets, we're selling, raffling off the ticket, or round trip ticket to Macedonia through Turkish Airlines. So find Ashley and get your raffle tickets, and now love your chicken.
Thank you. I want to know, when is going to be the, okay, I'll step to my left.
Thank you.
Thank you. Macedonian baš.
Now's your chance to buy the raffle tickets. Ashley's got them. 5 more minutes, and we're going to draw the winner.
Can I change the destination real quick?
Round trip tickets on Turkish Airlines. Macedonia, travel tickets, $10, drawing in 5 minutes.
Thank you. comfortable.
Hey, everyone, we're going to draw the raffle. And Lotaria does a Ovrata Cagata de Macedonia. E você se uma tuxa que é Lúmia. Точно ке има честа е конзулато, генералниот конзул Јако Преджели.
Ај, дај, господа, носам среќа се. Да гледам и не гледам.
Како саке?
Кажете која е доста. Бројот? Срешен одлупник е